Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time we're going to talk about a new DC power supply from Hewlett Packard. So this model is the 6213A. Look at that tiny little plastic thingy here, right? This looks like one of the super duper cheapos ones. I mean, really? Would you think that this is a real Hewlett Packard one? That was my first kind of feeling when I saw this one. And then I did a little bit of Googling around, and yes, it is a fact. This is an HP in a complete plastic cheapo looking kind of style, and they actually made many different variants of this model. So this is the 6213, and that one is 0 to 12 volts. They also made 30 volts, 60 volts, and so on, and exactly the same tiny little footprint. It's really nice and compact and all that kind of, but it's really this kind of plastic, no screws. It's this new sexy design where you stick in a screwdriver and do the clickety clack, and then you can open stuff like that. I don't know. I kind of not like that really. The other models more or less normally have this little on up here, so that means you flip this switch up, then it's turned on. And this one is missing, or it was never there. The meter, you switch between voltage or amps, like that. And then ground is misleading. Ground is connected to your mains connectors, earth. So this one is not the ground or the return, this is earth. The minus here, that is your DC power return path. So that is how it works. This one should definitely be renamed to Earth. And why is this not green? Yeah, I can't tell you, but that is definitely bad. That should be green. The knobs you can really recognize. Ooh, that is funny. Those are definitely HP. And that one is a normal pot meter, but that one is a wire wound type. Yeah, what else can I say about this one? It got the right sticker, so all that is correct. And there is another sticker, half an ampere classic. And then there's another sticker here about mains voltage and blah, 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 blah. And all that looks completely genuine. Hewlett Packard, all that kind of goody-goody, 250 volts, fantastic. So I should be able to plug this directly in. What I want to do is I want to open this first and perform a little bit of a visual inspection, because I got no clue about its current state.
Yeah, that's the chassis, right? There's even a little PCB around the output connectors for sensing and all that, and voltage switching and stuff. So how old is this thing? I was not able to find any schematics, by the way. Maybe I'm not the smartest when it comes to Googling around. So if you can find schematics, please give me some links.
But what I can find is date codes. 68. And 68 as well here. So, I mean, really? It is that old, and you don't see any op amps or any more modern kind of stuff. And it's those type of pot meters, they were also very, very normal back in the 60s and 80s, 70s. It's definitely that old. That is funny. I must have been sleeping under a rock or something, because I've not seen any of those super cheap HP products. So 69. So the highest number is the date code of my unit, right? So far we're up to 69. So that gotta be the output series transistor. Interesting, isn't it?
We're inside and I'm already testing stuff here, and I got about 40 millivolts of ripple peak. And let me turn on the light. So that's amps, 1 amp of load. And here's the funny thing. This is 1 amp of load, 0 amp of load. It's the same ripple. That is a very interesting observation. So how is this interesting? And it's also the same no matter what output voltage you have. Look at that. Exactly the same, right?
Let's look a little bit more in this 1968 unit. See, here is a neon bulb for power on indication. I mean, it's all yelling and screaming 1968. And this big, nice meter. I would have loved to have a little bit of light in the meter instead of this one. This is probably just me. That could have been a little bit more sexy. But other than that, I'm actually liking it a little bit more and more by every minute I play with it. I must admit, it is kind of cute, this little design. So I'll try and see a little bit harder if I can Google some more information. I really would like to see where's this ripple coming from. But I only see 3 big capacitors. I mean, maybe I should just take my probe and see if there is 40 millivolts on one of these, right? So I was able to find, they call this a service manual, but it's not really, it doesn't contain the schematic, but I found specifications, and it says the ripple is 1 millivolt peak. From 0 to 20 megahertz, and I see 40 millivolts peak. So I've been probing around on the different capacitors in here, and this is the output capacitor. This is doing some other kind of stuff. I don't know exactly what that is doing, and that one must be the main rectifier capacitor, main storage, right? Because see, we got all those diodes and stuff, and then we got that one close to the linear transistor regulator thingy. So I think I'm just gonna change these 3 and see if that has any effect. So I am in the middle of changing the capacitors. It's actually a little bit interesting to see the size difference. This one got much less internal resistance. It's the same, well, it's a little bit more, 2250 volts. This one is 2028 volts. And this one is about half the internal resistance. But it was not this capacitor that puked. It's actually the other one down here. It's called C5. I don't know if you can see the slimy stuff on the PCB here. But there's actually evidence of
capacitor acid all over the PCB here. So that leaked all over everything, causing ripple voltage currents leakage thingy to affect the output. So I think that is actually what is the main problem here. That is, I need to clean the PCB. All this ripple and stuff here still drives me a little bit nuts. As you can see here, I've lowered the ripple to about 30 millivolts peak after I put in new capacitors. So it wasn't entirely that. I also cleaned up the entire area with that leaked capacitor. And probably it damaged some of the components or stuff. I can't really see that. So now I'm trying to probe around here. Meanwhile, I did find another model's schematic. That schematic looks like it is 99% the same of this unit. I'll try to put in the schematic here so you can see what this is more or less all about. It is from another model called the 6240, so that is a different voltage. Also, it uses a little IC with all the important resistors integrated into one chip. And the model that I got here, as you can see in this area here, I don't have this chip. So that means all my important resistors, they are not that important. They're just the regular resistors. And if we look at this schematic with all the super duper important resistors put into this IC, there are of course the resistors around the current amplifier and the voltage amplifier. Some of those, all those resistors that's marked like that, those are inside this this IC. And again here. Yeah, and one more here, right? So yeah. But I still expect more or less this voltage stuff here and this power supply here to be more or less the same in mine. I don't know if it is there lying in the data sheet or if mine is just like 30 times worse than it's supposed to be. So I don't know if this is a dead end or whatever it is, because everywhere I measure, everything is like, there's no defect parts. So why the hell do I have all this ripple on the output? It's supposed to compensate for this, and this system was like supposed to be to working, and it is definitely doing everything right. Voltage regulation and current regulation and everything is just perfectly fine, but haha. Of course I fixed it. You're not going to believe it. So of course it was a design problem. This, the whole implementation about how the tracks go around and how everything here is connected, it's just completely wrong. It's not optimal for ripple. So I don't know if you can see what I've done here, but this is the windings for this auxiliary supply. Let me show you this on the schematic. So here's the auxiliary supply, and you can imagine that the ripple current and the ripple voltage here is going straight to the output. So this is the output, right? And this is the sense, the positive sense that is connected here to the middle. So all those voltages, they follow the input voltage up and down. And all those voltages, they are used for everything when it comes to voltage regulation and all that kind of stuff. It's all done here. So this needs to be nice and clean. But the way that that the tracks here and the connections here and everything here is done, it's just not isolated really. This creates a lot of ripple into the entire system. So what I've done is I've isolated this with a cut here, put in diodes and put in a new capacitor. So, well, this is the original one, but I cut it and added this. So this is my final circuit,
And so now I have a local system here with all the ripple and stuff that is completely isolated. And I got two 10 ohm resistors. So it's isolating all that kind of nasty stuff from the good and important part. And this is just the same capacitor as that one, right? And I got plenty of space to implement this. And now this system here is nice and clean. And as you can see here, this is the same view as before. And now it's nice and fine. I can even turn on and off 100%. So this is full load. So we see this, okay, that is dumb. Like that, right? So this is a load dump. And then we get only 20 millivolts up, and then it's going back into regulation. We can also do it the other way around, I guess, if we are not like that. So this is a load added from 0 to 1 amp. It's only dropping 20 millivolts. And my ripple here is really nice and fine. So I think this concludes this video. It is possible to fix this old design from 1969 or something like that. And this is probably how they are all designed, and they are completely lying in the specifications about this ripple, because there's definitely nothing wrong in this entire system here. I've been through this a million times, and everything here is correctly. There is no components that's defect or anything. It's just not any better to begin with. So thank you very much for watching. I hope to see you soon again. Bye bye.